Hello and welcome to Tabor Talks. If you see a need, take the lead. Today we are going to interview Mr. Habibur Nabi, General Secretary, ISC Embassy of India, Doha, Qatar. Sir, we thank you for your presence today. Today we are going to discuss about a very important topic of today's generation, that is how to manage studies with extracurricular activities. So, we'll begin our interview now. So, what is the role of extracurricular activities in today's life, you know, in today's youth generation? What would be it, how it helps in shaping your future actually?
Extracurricular activities is part of the human, and every student, as you have said, that he or she must be involved in the extracurricular activities because it enhances it gives a lot of benefits to the student, like in the field of communication, in the field of interaction, in the field of how to manage the things. Even when they are meeting different people, they know their views, they understand. So it really develops their IQ as well as it helps them in their future life, that how they have to interact with the community, because in the community there are different type of people. So when you interact in the student life and you are involved in the cultural activities, so it gives you a lot of confidence when you comes in the practical life. And especially when you comes in the practical life, you will you have not to be trained in the practical life, because you are already trained when you were student, where you have faced. When you do the extracurricular activities, you learn a lot of management, where you have to go, how you have to take the permission, how you have to carry out that function, how you have to do the sequencing of the program, how you have to respect the guest, how you have to manage the audience. So there are so many things which you learn in the early stages of your life when you are studying. Side by side, these things also helps you how you have to manage your studies, because when you are managing the extracurricular activities, so you can see, okay, I can do this much work in 3 hours, so I have to complete 5 chapters or 7 chapters, how I can complete them. So it gives you a lot of confidence that yes, when I can do that job, I can do this job. See, education is very easy comparing to the sports and the extracurricular activities, because in extracurricular activities you are dealing with different people, with different entities, with different organizations. But in education you are dealing with yourself only. There you have to manage yourself. There you have to make sure that those others are in line of your requirement. So that is much difficult job than studies. So once a student is really mature in that, he can excel in the studies, plus his brain level, his thinking, his IQ, plus the way he can manage the things. It's really, I think a lot of confidence comes to the student.
Okay, so basically we have the extracurricular activities gives you the practical knowledge of how to carry out yourself in the world. Yes. So, sir, now I would like to give you a situation. Assume you're interviewing two candidates. One is highly good in studies, but only in studies, and the second one is average in studies, but have a very vast extracurricular activity background. So, what would be your preference?
My preference will be the extracurricular activities, because that is student, when you see, maybe there is a topper, but when he faces 5 people in front of him and they are asking him any question, then maybe he is nervous, he is not able to show his potential, what he has. So in that case, when you see the guy who is dealing with the extracurricular activities, he will manage the answer within seconds, because he is used to that. He know how to handle the situation, how to act in which situation. And even if he doesn't know the answer, the reply which he will give you will be very satisfactory. because he has that potential and that confidence. And the most important thing in any work is the confidence. If you don't have the confidence, whatever knowledge you have, I think that is helpful, but not that much, as you are confident and as well as you have the knowledge. So in my opinion, I will always suggest or recommend the one who is very good in extracurricular activities. So at least you can use him because he is active. If I am a topper and I sleep 6 hours or 10 hours a day and just study, I think this is not practical nowadays in the life. You have to be very active and you should be able to mingle in all walks of life. That is another important thing, because some of the studious students, they just come and discuss the things and they are limited. As you, scientists, you can say, they looks like they are in their own world. Yes. So that doesn't goes. Maybe he is good in research, but he cannot be a very good teacher, or he cannot be a very community person. Yeah, Lisi, IAS, IPS, all these people, they are sharp. They are all sports personality. And they are not only that, let me give you an example. My daughter, she did medical from one of the top world 5 colleges, which is Cornell. And you know their what is their method of selection? They observe the student for the 2 years. They observe the student, how much he or she is involved in cultural activities, how much he or she is involved in social activities, how much he or she is involved in extracurricular activities, how much he is involved in the community service. And nowadays, the community service is the most important thing. Then, like that, they categorize 7-8 categories and they give, say, 15 marks to each category. Out of that, maybe 30 marks they give to whatever percentage of marks he or she have achieved. Then out of that, if she gets 60% and the 6 professors, they accept her, then only she will get the white coat, otherwise no. So this is the criteria of the world top medical colleges. And even if you see, if I am a doctor or if I am an engineer and I don't know how to mingle with the people, I don't know how to interact with the people, if I don't know how to solve the problems, if I don't know how to get the work done from the my juniors, how to get the work done from my seniors, it means you don't have the qualities. Maybe you are a good student, topper student, but that doesn't help in the field. So in the field, I personally feel that anyone who is good in sports, who is good in extracurricular activities, will always be beneficial for that institution where he will be working, he or she will be working.
Yes, means you will gain confidence at each step when you do extracurricular activities, either it's sports, debates or anything. Do you have a particular preference in extracurricular activities which a student must have?
What I will suggest, the first preference I will give a student, a community service. Community service, beside that, like Aligarh is famous for this. I mean, they take care of their brothers, sisters, they take care of their colleagues who are living in the hostel. So many things they do, and they do without knowing to him or her that they are supporting him. This is one of the best services. Even I don't know now, but when I was studying here 43 years back, I know that the professors, the wardens, the provosts, the teachers, they used to support the students like their children. And the children doesn't know who is doing all these things. So when he get educated and he get a good job, maybe he don't know how all these things happen. So this is the beauty of the Aligarh, because Aligarh and especially we have something. If we can do something for others, it's really, you will feel light, you will feel honor and privilege that at least I do something for somebody. If anyone is wearing, say, $100,000 clothes, but that is, there is no value because he is wearing for himself. But if he give $100 to somebody, that is what matters. So that type of upbringing, that type of message should be always with him. Even if there is a person, old person, and he or she want to cross the road, if we take him and cross the road, this is one of the biggest humanity. This is what we are lacking now. We are all thinking about ourselves. Unless and until we don't think about others, we are nothing. When we will think about others, other will think about us. Because you may be in that shoe anytime. It is not possible that you are not in that shoe now. Maybe after 1 month you are in that shoe. So at that time, whatever you have done, God will make sure that someone will come and help you. Yes, and he will grab your hand and help you.
So what are some tips that you will suggest our viewers about how they can manage their studies with extracurricular activities?
Studies is something which is, there are two type of students. One student who is really sharp. They are very sharp. Some students, they need little bit extra efforts. So it all depends you fall in which category. If you are a sharp student, you can manage that in next every day. You will make sure that 2 to 1 hour, 2 hour, whatever time you need, you will complete the things. And then balance of the things, either you will spend with the any, you can join any NGO. Like they are doing a lot of things. So in that, each child, there is schools on wheels. So even if he is a good student, he can take a child and he can teach him. That is also a community service. He can go to the hospital, he can take care, okay, there is emergency ward, maybe he can do something there, he can go to any other ward. So there are so many ways he can contribute to the community, and at the end of the day, all those good things will always help him and will always be positive in his life. So that is what I believe. And the most important thing is humanity, which is number one. That the first thing he should do, humanity, then he should also some physical things like sports and other things, so that he will keep himself fit. He will enjoy the, because healthy, wealthy and wise, these says. But if a person who is really healthy, it means he is wise also. This is what I believe. And most of the sportsmen, they learned, the sportsman has certain qualities that his thinking power is very fast. Within a second, he have to take the decision. He is very punctual about the time. He is very disciplined because he knows that if I am going in the ground, I have to be in the proper kit. I have to be in the proper dress. I have to be on time. I have to do the warm up. So he learns something which he can manage in his life. And same thing applies when he comes to his, second part or third part of his life, which you can say after the graduation or after this.
So, but it means you don't need a big flyer and a gathering of 1,000 people to do.
No. Even if someone is shy, I will prefer him. He should go in front of a mirror and he should talk. He or she should talk and just has confidence of that. Even she can have some pets and she can talk to them. She will get the confidence, he or she, whatever it is. So there are so many ways. All these things are given in the, you go to any website, but at the end of the day, you should have the confidence and you should be able to communicate whatever you have in your heart. If that message reaches to the others, that is the most important thing.
Yes. So have confidence in what you do. So sir, what do you think that today's market, and by market I mean corporate market as well as educational institute, prefer their ideal candidate to be like?
It is not now. I am talking to you about 45 years back. One of the banks was this was one of the top banks in the world, and they were recruiting they were doing the recruitment for the bank. They never recruit a genius. They were recruiting smart students. And those smart students, it's not necessary also that they should have an economic background or they should have an MBA in this and this. No. They just want the smart students, then they train themselves for 1 or 2 years. And after training, it was BCCI, the bank. So, and then they were putting them on the job. So, see, once you are smart, your way of thinking, your way of talking, your way of handling of the things, you can see the difference between the others and this. So it is, even now, all of you are still a student, but you are doing a lot of things. What is this? This is a smartness. This is thinking. This is your confidence that you can do this. And you are doing it. So the example is here itself.
So you don't have to be a genius to get a job. You have to be smart and intellectual by yourself. So now there's going to be a personal question. So there always comes a time in our lives when nothing goes in our way and we feel hopelessness and we feel like giving up on everything. So is there a time like that in your life too, and what was it?
See, Alhamdulillah, it never happened to me, but I believe that whatever happens to you or in your life, you should be always thankful to God, and you should say Alhamdulillah. Because if there is anything not happening, there might be a reason behind that. Because sometimes we think, even I can tell you, 35, 40 years back, I was saying that I know Theodolite, I know this, but I don't know PGM. So just I was thinking, so there was one Sufi type fellow, he told me, maybe you don't know. Why you don't know this? Because God knows what is good for you, what is bad for you. So if you don't know, never be repent for that. Always be thankful to God. And this I have observed in my life, that there are so many things which I don't know, but when I need, it automatically comes in my mind. I mean, it is not like that I am a failure there. It will come in my mind. But it doesn't mean that there is a system, it will come. You have to work whatever assignment is given to you. Even if suppose I am coming for any work, I have to make sure that I have studied something regarding that. I have discussed, I have prepared myself. Because these are the things which helps you to further enhance whatever knowledge you have. So one should be always thankful to God, and whatever he or she is getting, he should be, appreciate that, and never be so much greedy about things. Because there are certain things which are beyond our control. Even like, for example, just now we are sitting here, we don't know what will happen in the next moment. Nobody knows. So our life is very uncertain, but that doesn't mean we should stop doing the things. We should plan the things, we should work hard, we should focus on the things, we should try to give our best, we should always try to motivate the others. And the most important thing in the life, appreciate others. Never try to discourage anyone, because once you will appreciate others, they will also appreciate you, and your confidence will increase. So this appreciation of each and everyone is also one of the very important thing which we miss. We always think we are the best. No one is the best. God only knows, or that person himself knows who is the best. So one should not be, if anyone is good or having some lot of prosperity in his life, we should say Alhamdulillah, God give him more. But you should also work hard. And if you, there is a very good example. Why you see like this? See, there are so many things. So you should get a message from there. And then you will say, no, I am thankful to God and this and this. So you have to focus the reality. It is not necessary that one should always look up. He should look in the middle and always try to be, always try to manage to go within that. No need to fly high, no need to go low, but go in the middle and try to be natural. Don't try to be artificial. Yes. That is another important thing, yes.
So be a believer and have faith in what you do.
Yes, yes.
Is what takes you to move on to the life. So there's always a decision we make that we're proud of, And what, according to you, was that life-changing decision you made ever?
I am very privileged in this that from my student life, God always give me greater heights. When I joined the job, out of billions of people, I get very top jobs, world number one company I work. So I was always privileged in this. But I never change my style of working. I always remain, even so many years I am coming to Aligarh, but in Aligarh, nobody knows what is my level. Maybe the outer people, they know, because here I live very simple. So what I will suggest to everyone, be what you are. Remember your past, always respect your elders, always respect your parents, always respect your friends, whatever condition they are. That is an economical situation. But at the end of the day, you should remain as you were. Don't change yourself based upon the money, based upon the position, based upon anything. Just remain as you are. And be humble, be polite, be friendly with everyone. If you can do something for other, please do it without showing it off. And if you cannot do, don't criticize. Leave him or her as it is. So in this, I am really thankful to Almighty and to my parents that in so many years I have to never look back, and God give me more and more blessings, and I am really thankful to God. And the one may be one of the reason, because I keep my heart clean, and whatever is in my heart that I always keep on my tongue. I am fair with the people, I am honest, because I believe since beginning three things. One is that you have to work hard as much as you can. Number two, you should be always honest. And number three, that remember God in any way. So you will never be deprived of anything.
So what was the time when you actually get a clearer picture of you, of who you want to be in your future, like as you are now?
I never thought that what I want to be, simply because I love sports. So I was always in sports, and so many things come on my way. I just keep on doing it. Some of the things, even they are not, I am not very much related to that, but still, because I saw that it is for community, I did it. And but what I will say that due to sports, it helps a lot to me in my career, because when I was in the Aligarh University and in 1973 to 78, I mean, so many functions we did. I mean, up to 12,000 student capacity, the University Games Committee function we did. So the confidence in the university we receive, Pakistan hockey captain Salahuddin, we received this, what is this, General T.N. Gadhok, and D.K. Barua, the Congress President, the Sher-e-Kashmir, Mufti of Makkah, so many dignitaries, 2-3 head of the states. So all these things, even this Nobel laureate Abdul Salam Sahab, I took him to this tailor, and within the night we get his Sherwani stitch from Shamshad. So all these things, Tasveer Mahal, actually, we get his Sherwanis. So when you meet these people, you learned a lot. So many chief ministers, ministers, they came to the university. So when you listen to even Sheikh Zayed bin Sultan Al Nahyan, he came in 1976, and we gave him a reception from the Students' Union as well as in the Engineering College. Then he now. So there are so many things which we did in the student life. When we are in the practical life, that life looks more glorious than what we have today. Even now we have met so many people, but that time it was really honor. And I thank to Aligarh Muslim University that they gave us all these opportunities, and we are thankful to Sir Syed Ahmed Khan that due to this institution today whatever we are, otherwise we don't know whether maybe we are also pulling a rickshaw or we are a beggar, we don't know what would be our career. So we should be highly thankful to this alma mater, and I request all the students that don't think about yourself, think about the alma mater, think about the mission of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan, what was his mission, why, and when you see that all over the world millions of students they are on very excellent positions and they are doing so, they should all think about the university. Politics is something, but when the interest of the university comes, we should be all whatever is beneficial for the university. That should be our motto. We should, and even among ourselves, we should always have healthy discussions. We should not have unhealthy discussion. It doesn't make sense. Always have healthy discussion. Yeah, healthy criticism is also good. If there is anything wrong, yes, you people should know how to put that in a way that things can be resolved. Not never have a fight. No. Most of the issues in the world can be resolved by dialogue. So dialogue is one of the things, but you should know how you have to start the dialogues. I mean, which level, maybe it will fail in the beginning, but with these discussions and the naturally things can be resolved much better than.
So there's always something, something, place, or person that we're most attached to. So if someone's attached to something related to community service, what does it reflect about its personality, his or her personality?
What I think that if anyone who is attached to the community service, his heart will be very good. And even if he has whatever he has with him or her, he will be ready to give it to others. Plus, he will always have a pain for others, and whatever way he can help, naturally he or she will help, and the God also guide him in such a way that he can do so many things which he also don't know how it came. Like today I have come to your interview. I mean, I never expected, because tonight I am flying, but this is how things goes, that God send people, they come, they enjoy, they mix, and they appreciate you, you appreciate them. I mean, you people are doing a wonderful job, as I have come to know, and this is one of the beauty of the community service, that many people, they respect you, they listen to you, they always try to be like you, they always work for others, then they see the peace in their heart. The most important thing, how you get the peace. There are so many people in the world, they have millions of dollars, but they don't have peace because they are within themselves. They are not going out of that. They are not going to the needy people. They are not serving the people. How they can get the peace? Peace is something which is not easy. Money is not the solution of peace. Peace comes when you surrounding of your is peaceful.
Yes. So never forget your roots, where yes. You come from. Okay, so sir, summing up this interview, one last question I would like to ask you, that what would be your message to today's youth? What they should focus on?
My message will be to the youth that the most important thing for our youth is they should be very highly educated. Whatever field they choose, is it not necessary that they should be engineer, doctor? They can go to any field, but they should excel in that. They should respect their parents. They should respect their neighbors. They should do community service. They should make sure that they remember God by any way, whatever way. The other thing, whenever you are speaking anything, make sure that you don't hurt the others. If you respect others, they will respect you. Never go for discussing those things which are immaterial. If someone is black, someone is white, what matters? It is all from Almighty. If someone is following this religion, someone is following the religion, this is his personal thing. So never go in those things. Always be a community member. Wherever you go, try to spread the message of peace and love. And that should be the youth has energy, the youth has power.